People of Southern Cameroons, fellow Ambazonians, there are those who are now saying that we are dead and we are out. Yes, many of our brothers and sisters have been killed and are still being killed. We might be down, but I assure you, we are not out yet. Be very careful not to count someone out simply because he or she is down. Mr. Biya should not be quick to call the killings a victory. To Mr. Biya and Mr. Filimoria, he might have scored a goal by taking this very bitter pill. This time, however, he must just have beaten too much than he can swallow. Just yesterday, two people were shot in Kemo, in Manu County, after the passage of the team of elites who were supposed to have visited them to dialogue with them, to dialogue with their own people. Our learned professor who led that delegation to Imoja, we want you to know that behind your team's visit, your people are still being killed. The chief and the team who visited Akwaya, we want you all to know that more people are still fleeing Akwaya to Nigeria after your passage. Is it not shameful that you, chief, and Biya surrogates, you went to Nigeria asking the chiefs of Nigeria to send back your own people, chief? You asked the chiefs of Nigeria to send back people to Akwaya. And by the way, we must know, to go to Akwaya, one has to go through Nigeria. What country would abandon its own people for 56 years? That to go to a town in your own country, you have to stamp your passport and travel through another country. This is the lot that people in Akwaya, this is the lot that people in Justice Ayapo's place have been going through for 56 years. Yes, this is where Lord Justice Ayapo Abine comes from. And 56 years after independence, one cannot visit Akwaya without going through Nigeria if you have to visit by car. Let me get back to the visit of Mr. Biya's elites to our people. The chief and his delegation not only went and asked the people to come back, they were sent to Akwaya. The border that was closed between Cameroon and Nigeria was exceptionally open to our chief and his team. But when they got to Akwaya, they realized that most of the villages that had been abandoned, those villages had been deserted. Most of the villagers have fled to Nigeria. They have fled to Nigeria as refugees. But Mr. Biya's delegation did not end there. They shamelessly went back to Nigeria and they told the Nigerian chiefs, the Nigerian people, that all is well back home and that peace has returned. That peace has returned in their villages. They met and urged some Nigerians to send back their people to Akwaya, to send back the refugees that Mr. Biya has created in the country he calls his home. Someone might ask, what do people of Akwaya, what are they fleeing from? Let me tell you, they are fleeing from the attacks of Mr. Biya's helicopters. Because day after day, since the 22nd of September 2017, the people of Akwaya are bombarded by helicopter gunshots. Military helicopters ordered by the governor of the Southwest region are shooting on armed people. And they are forcing them to flee into neighboring Nigeria. This situation, as pathetic as it sounds, is ongoing as we speak. There are many cases of there are deception. There are many cases of diarrhea amongst our people who have flown into Nigeria, who have fled into Nigeria as refugees. Pregnant women are giving birth in the bushes, carrying children, wrapping children in plant leaves. Many children have sores on their legs after the long trek, after the long walk through bushes to seek shelter in Nigeria. As pathetic as this situation is, you have to remember, Boko Haram caused a refugee situation in northern Cameroon. Today, Mr. Biya's forces are causing a refugee situation on the land, on the people of Southern Cameroons. What tragedy can befall a people than to be sent away from their own land for nothing? The government of Nigeria last week reported that 40,000 Southern Cameroonian refugees were in Nigeria, with about 30,000 of them in the Cross River State alone. We want to thank the government and the people of Nigeria for opening their homes to our people. We want to particularly thank the governor of Cross River State for going out of his way to welcome our people, that he himself calls their brothers and sisters. Thousands of refugees are streaming in, chased away from what should be their own country by Mr. Biya's forces. When a person opens a container that's meant for goods only, and pushes 36 people into that container, locks the container and walks away, comes back days later to pull out 36 corpses, remove them from a container and bury them in mass graves, what do you call that? That's called barbarity. We know the case of Mayor Ekema, Mr. Ekema, mayor of Oya, who used his gun and shot down two people, killing one of them. In the course of the incident, Mr. Ekema's house and property and cars were destroyed. But what happened after that? Not only did Biya governor call us dogs and order his forces to shoot and kill unarmed people, we know now many are killed and thousands are wounded. But days later, a delegation of Mr. Biya's people visited Mr. Ekema. They went to Mr. Ekema's house to sympathize with him for the loss of his property. They even provided him with financial assistance. And they got back to their activities without mention of the dead and the wounded people of Southern Cameroons. On their way to Mr. Ekema's house, these people drove past mortuaries with our fallen heroes in them. These people drove past hospitals with many of our wounded. They drove past prisons with thousands of our people locked up. Locked up unjustly. Locked up because they are standing for what is right. Locked up and killed because they were out in a peaceful demonstration. These actions of Mr. Biya's people in that visit to Mr. Ekema is not only cruel, but it confirms to their country and to the world that they consider us as dogs. Even a dog deserves better than these people displayed. How many people still doubt that we cannot live with people like Ekema's guests? Those people sent by Mr. Biya, how many people doubt that we cannot live with them anymore? How many of us have not finally agreed that in the eyes of Mr. Biya's people, we are only dogs? Action speaks louder than words they always say. These people do not have to say it as their brother the governor did. They don't have to call us dogs. By their actions, they told us in no uncertain terms that we are dogs. By their actions, they have spoken so loudly that we are only considered by them as dogs. You know, they say your actions speak so loudly, I can't hear what you say. I want to remind my people, we have got to the middle of the ocean. It's a choice. Either we go back to where we started, or we go to the other side. We are resolute to go to the other side. And we know that it will be worth it. The price to pay for this freedom we seek, the price might be high. We are now paying that price, but we shall know that it will be worth it. I want to thank the United Nations High Commission, the High Commission for Refugees, for attending to the situation created by Mr. Jabir on our people. The High Commission for Refugees has acted quickly and forcefully. We know that their teams are counting the numbers of our people in the various towns and villages at the border states in Nigeria. And they are providing immediate relief to our people, especially taking care of the sick in hospital for urgent medical attention. And we want to continue to thank them for the work they are doing. And we ask ourselves, what government chases its own people out to become refugees in another nation? Mr. Diaz, what government chases its own people out to become refugees in another country? Tell me, Mr. Biya's forces are beating and killing Southern Cameroonians. They are killing them out of their land. A peaceful, unarmed people, they are being tortured out of the land that God has given them. Women and children are traveling in the forest and in the bushes for days to seek shelter from a neighboring country. What government does that to its people? They are seeking shelter because they are being killed by Mr. Biya's forces. What government does that to its people? So we are therefore, we are asking the Secretary General of the United Nations, we are asking him to refer to his officers who are on ground in Southern Cameroon. They have been there for weeks, they have been there for months, some of them have been there from the start of this crisis. We are asking him to confer from them, let them give him the true numbers of the people that Mr. Biya's forces have killed, the numbers that have been wounded, tortured, maimed, raped, and those that have simply disappeared. We urge the Secretary General to call this situation what it is. The Secretary General must call this situation a genocide. He should use his office to request a peacekeeping force to come and protect the people of this land. He recognized the urgency of this moment, and we want him to ask Mr. Biya to organize a dialogue, a true dialogue, in which the United Nations, amongst others, will mediate. The Secretary General should ask Mr. Biya to ask his forces to immediately and effectively stop the killing of our people. Mr. Biya should ask his forces to retreat to his country.
Stop.
What?
The chroma behind
you. We want to remind the Secretary General.
Hold on. Okay.
We want to remind the Secretary General that he should not leave the Republic of Cameroon without actively engaging the people that Obia to resolve this crisis. We fear that if he does, if he leaves without engaging, it will escalate to levels never before seen. As a demonstration of the gravity of this situation, the Governing Council is calling for a complete and total ghost town on Friday. Friday, the 27th of October, we are calling for a complete ghost town. That's the day we are told the Secretary General will visit Cameroon. Everyone should stay indoors. Read your Bible, read your Quran, and pray to God. Nobody, I mean nobody, should go out. By the quiet streets of our villages and our towns, you should once again tell God and the visiting Secretary General that you have a problem. We are going to tell him we have a problem. We have a problem of identity, a problem that must be solved now. Mr. Secretary General, when you visit on Friday, please, we ask you to request Mr. Bia to accompany you in a flight over Southern Cameroons. And you will see for yourself, Mr. Secretary General, you will hear the cries of our people. In their silence, they will tell you that they have a problem. Fellow Ambazonians, fellow Southern Cameroonians, on Friday, we will once again have a chance to write a chapter of our very long story of suffering, of our long story of assimilation and our story of recolonization. I want you to close tight your doors and stay in your homes. By that action, you should tell the world that they should ask Mr. Biya's forces to leave your streets. There is nothing better than discovering your purpose. God brought us to this land, the land of the Southern Cameroons, the land in Outer Ambazonia, that you all know. God brought us to this planet for our children and our children's children to know where we come from, a land we can call our own. He did not bring us to Ambazonia by air. God brought us to this land so that we can claim it, and we should call it ours. And no one, and we mean no one, can take that away from us. This is a fight we're fighting. This is a fight we're going to jail for. And this is a fight we're dying for. Long live Southern Cameroons. Long live Ambazonia. And God bless you.
Whew.
My goodness. Not long.
Ambazonia.